Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about zinc, what it is and why you need to take it. So zinc is an important mineral in our body, and its relevance to the current pandemic is certainly top of mind for so many people. It's something that you may have heard about and maybe not, and I will be talking a little bit about that. And this, because it is an essential mineral, meaning our body does not produce it. It's something that needs to be taken from the outside, and it is a trace mineral. And after iron, it is the most abundant trace mineral in the human body. And it's required for many, many functions in our bodies. It's a cofactor for thousands and thousands of different enzymes. It also helps with transcription factors and for structural proteins. So it has a lot to do with muscle mass. And because it can't be stored, it's usually consumed daily in our diet, and some foods are better than others in terms of the quality and the quantity of zinc. So that's something that I'll share in another episode. Now, the thing about zinc deficiency is that unfortunately it can't be well tested in our blood. So if you go to your doctor and you're wondering what your zinc status is, it's very difficult to test for in the blood because it's often sitting in different organ systems and tissues of the body. So what people don't realize is that most of us actually may have a zinc deficiency, and that's why it's so important for our immune system, for our, in terms of our muscle mass, for our skin, and so many other benefits of zinc, that we make sure that we're getting enough of it daily. Now, in the news, certainly more recently with the pandemic, there was definitely a correlation between zinc deficiency and outcomes of viral infections. And in this study, what the researchers found was that low zinc levels and the viral load definitely had a correlation. And what researchers then questioned was, you know, how important is it for us to have enough zinc and to certainly have a more positive outcome in terms of having a viral infection? So what's really interesting is that most, if not all, of the symptoms of a certain viral infection also match that of having a zinc deficiency. So, you know, this is something that in another video I'm going to share all those symptoms of a zinc deficiency, and you'll be shocked to find out, you know, the correlations and, you know, the similarities between having a viral infection. So the RDA for zinc is 8 milligrams per day for adults, so both men and women, and for pregnant women needing a little bit more, the RDA is 12 milligrams. So thanks for watching me today. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring. If this video helps you to learn something new, I would love for you to give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button, and also turn on those notifications so you always get my newest and latest uploads. Be sure to share this video as well with someone who you think might benefit from this important information about zinc. I'll see you next time. Remember to always take care of your good health and to do it naturally.